Hello, my friends. This is Rick Lepine, online entrepreneur and trainer. Hey, today I wanted to ask you, are you getting enough eyeballs on your presentation? If you're in a network marketing business, home-based business profession, you know, it all matters on how many eyeballs that we get, of course, people to take a look at our presentation, our business. If you're not getting enough, then you're not talking to enough people. And I want to give you three great sources, okay, on how to generate those leads. The second thing I want to touch is how to, again, book the appointment and have the prospect more likely to honor that appointment so that obviously you can get that presentation in front of them. All right, so let's go over this real quickly. The three sources of leads are this. First, your warm market, of course, but here's a different way to approach your warm market. Text them, okay? Keep the curiosity factor open. Just say, hey, coffee, question mark. See what happens. Ask, you know, see what they want to do. You know, try to say, hey, I got something to show you. Can I meet you at tonight at your place at 7? Question mark. Hey, I got to come over tonight. I got something I got to show you. Question mark. Anything like that at all. Text messaging is a great way, again, to get your information in front of somebody, okay? The next way is what we call the can you help me approach. So maybe you don't have the best relationship. Maybe you've been through a lot of these deals before and they're kind of burnt out. Just bottom line, say, hey, can you help me? I got into something. I'm really excited about it. I don't want you to join. I don't want you to buy anything. Put your credit card and checkbook away. I just want to show it to you. That's all I want to do. And if I do that, I kind of check my mark with my leadership. Is that cool? Okay. Then I obviously set the appointment that way. Another great way, of course, is using social media. Okay, and hitting up people that are active on the right-hand side, if you're using your, of course, your computer, to say who's active right now or how recently were they active. Just, you know, send a question like, what's up? Okay, question mark. Find out if you can start a conversation, okay? The second way is social media, but here's the greatest way about social media is this. If you can go into social media and go into Facebook and type in your nearest largest town and then networking or entrepreneur or business, see what groups come up, become members of those groups, and then start friending those members of those groups. It's a great way to get a hold of people, all right? So you can do the same thing on LinkedIn, the same thing on Google+, okay? That's your next best source, okay? Your third source is, of course, network meetings, okay? Or business entrepreneur type meetings. Go to meetup.com, find out where they're at. Also, when you do the search graph in Facebook, you'll find out if they're having them locally, and then, of course, find out when the next meeting is. Sometimes they meet weekly, monthly. Pardon me. They use probably monthly is typical. Okay, so go out there and try to find, you know, those type of networking meetings and then pull business cards. Okay, it's a great three ways to get leads. Again, to try to set the appointment to get the presentation in front of their eyeballs. All right, now how to get the prospect to honor that appointment so that you don't have to, you know, keep making these appointments. And you should be getting at least 50%, if not more, of people honoring those appointments. If not, here's a better way to do it, all right? So when you are forming them, in other words, family, occupation, recreation, or what we call motivation or message, and you're finding out what problems they have that either your product or service and or your business, financially, of course, can assist them, what you're gonna use, you're gonna use those hurts in the actual appointment that you're trying to set with them. Okay, so what I'm saying is let's say you're finally asked the question, well, are you open to, you know, a side project if you didn't currently interfere with what you're doing? Or if you've already talked to them and say, well, look, if I can show you a way that you can have that vacation of your life, or you can bring your spouse home or put your kids through college or pay off your debts, would you be open to taking a look at information that would help you do that? Okay. You want to use, the problems that they're having in your setting up the appointment to get the information to them, okay? And then, of course, confirm it and say again, okay, so at Tuesday at, you know, 8 o'clock p.m., I'm going to show you a way to bring your wife home or show you a way to put your kids to school or whatever that is, okay? So they're more apt to honor the appointment, all right? And then, of course, you know, make sure you follow up with them. And when you set the appointment, make sure you're, again, doing your two-on-ones or one-on-ones, hotel meetings, whatever else. It's great to have other support. Okay, so use those three-way calls, whatever you need to use. All right, so that's my advice to you today. Again, get those three sources of leads, start hitting them up, and make sure that you use the problem that you're trying to solve in the statements that you're trying to make in order to set the appointment. All right, this is Rick. Hope you got something from that today. Please get a hold of me, comment below, share this with your friends on social media. I appreciate it. And of course, if you are in my blog, go to the top right here and you're going to see the Instagram cheat sheet that I have. Please use that. And you know, you get my blog updates too. All right, this is Rick. Hope you got something out of that. This is Rick. Be blessed. Live free and prosper. Rick out.